God's not dead. He's surely alive. Amen. He's living in the inside. Was hulle nie smart gewees nie? Geef hulle nog so 'n klap. Amen. Prachtig, nee. Now for our youth squad. Just put your hands together for the youth squad. Matthew, brother Matthew, you can come to the front. Amen. One of the youth squad members. Amen. Lekker bedraf stap hier. Amen.
Isaiah 53:5.
Lift your voice.
He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. We like sheep have gone astray. We have led everyone on his own way, and the Lord had laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He was like a lamb brought to the slaughter, and a sheep before its shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. Luke.
It took me a few Luke years 25, to bring my business.
Luke 24:5-7. And as they were afraid, they bowed their faces to the earth, and they said to them, "Why do you seek the living amongst the dead? Don't you remember what he said to you when he was still in Galilee? Behold, the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men, and be crucified, and delivered, and rise again on the third day." John 11:5-6. And Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he may die, shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die." Do you believe this?
Hallelujah. Now for the youth squad. Amen. Put your hands together for the youth squad. Amen.
Lift your voice and shout the name Jesus. Oh, I believe that there's a better shout in you than that. I want everybody that's ever been healed by that name, ever been delivered by that name, lift up your voice and shout Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
Call that name. Call that name.
Jesus.
Come on, call that name.
Jesus.
Jesus. Come on, call that name. Call
Jesus.
That name.
Jesus.
Come on, I need to hear a church call the name.
Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
Pragtig gewees, nee. Ek het 'n paar moves geleer, hoor. Hey, pastor. Pa, next time gaan ek moves doen, pastor. Nie vandag, hoor. Amen. Gee die Here so 'n praise vir hulle. Amen. God has been faithful. Amen. We're going to have one more song as we prepare our hearts and minds for the word of God. Amen. Just receive this morning. Amen. Let's stand to our feet. Of the house, Dr. Patty Campbell. Amen.
Thank you. Amen. Ooh, wasn't that so powerful? Our youth, our children. Oh my goodness, I'm in awe of God, what he's doing in the house. Amen? We give God all the glory, all the honor, all the praise this morning. Today is Resurrection Sunday, Victory Sunday. And you know, every day, but especially every Sunday, must be Resurrection Sunday. And you will see on my status, is resurrection power. Our focus in life must be on the resurrection. Then we will not waver. The enemy wants us to waver. But it is the truth that he died and he rose again. That is our faith. Amen. So this morning I just want to just teach shortly on the fact, it's a fact that Jesus died. It is the truth, but it's a fact. Am I right? It's a fact. And the fulfillment and the promise that was fulfilled. So I just want to call youth squads to the front. Can they just come to the front? They know who they are. I think it's Jaden, Jada, and a friend. I just want to ask them questions, and I would like them to answer. Amen. 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 Can give it to Jada first. To Jada. Yeah. Jada, why do we celebrate Easter?
To celebrate the person who has died on the cross for our sins.
Amen. Give it a hand. And then,
Jade.
Oh, it's a lot of Jades and Jaden and Jada and Jade. Who was the first person to be resurrected?
Jesus.
Ooh, isn't it? He was the first person and the only person in the universe that was resurrected from the dead. Many people say, I wish somebody can come back, my grandma or grandpa, to tell me more about what happens after death. But Jesus is the one that actually died and he returned from the death to earth and he came to visit his disciples and appear to them. Am I right? Amen. Wow. Lastly, Jaden, that's all the J's. Who else will be resurrected because Jesus was resurrected?
We will be resurrected.
Give the Lord in. It's all because of Jesus. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Isn't that powerful? Wow. It is just amazing. You know, our focus must be on the resurrection in life. Then we will not waver. Our faith will be built on the rock Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. If we look at the cross is empty. The tomb is bare. Jesus cannot be found there. Amen. Glory, honor, and power to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords this morning. I'm in awe of our God, but it's all about love. Like the little one sang, it's love. It's all about his love for us. And you know, nothing will separate us from God's love. Nor height, nor depth, nor principality, nor any power will be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus, for your love this morning. We love you so much. And today, it's all about belief. The thieves on either side of the cross, the one did not believe. And he went to eternal damnation. The other one on the cross on the right-hand side of Jesus, he believed. And Jesus said to him, he said to Jesus, please remember me. And Jesus said, today you will be with me in paradise. So, that shows you immediately on the cross. Jesus took all our sin, all our shame. He took death upon himself. He became sin so that we might not live anymore according to sin, but that we might be the righteousness of God. Think about it. He took my sin, my past sin, my present sin, my future sin, on the cross. He took our sin on the cross. Who are we that, you know, that God is so mindful of us? He loves us so and he wants to reconcile. The cross gave us access to God. That separation is removed. And what is so powerful, God, I want to thank you for Jesus, for sending your son Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, that you came. And thank you, Jesus, that you made a way for the Holy Spirit to enter our hearts this morning. That the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead. Do you know that the Spirit of God raised Jesus, that photo please, the same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead lives now in us. Do you know that Jesus did not raise himself? The Spirit of God raised him from the dead. After that, we see the operation of the Spirit of God. The Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you and me who received him as Lord and Savior. Isn't that powerful? It's all about the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God raised Jesus from the dead. The Word of God is Spirit and is life. Don't take your eyes off Jesus. Don't take your eyes off the resurrection power of God. Keep focus. I like that Brother Eddie sang so beautiful. You know, you can walk on that waves. Don't take your eyes off Jesus like Peter did. He walked on the waves because his eyes was on the resurrecting power of God. And that the same spirit of him, think about it, who raised Jesus from the dead. You know, that day when he came out of death, whoa, he first went right into hell and he took the keys of death and hell. He destroyed death and he took the keys of hell and he overcame death once and for all. Amen. He don't need to die again. He's done it. When we believe it and we receive it, we have eternal life and abundant life on top of it, no matter what happens around us. We know he's the only one that died and he rose again the third day. No other God in the universe, the people that worships different gods and the religion. We went into the shop, we went to buy a gift for somebody, and this boy said, "I am, my parents are religious, but I'm not." I said, "It's not a religion, it's a relationship. Did you know that?" His eyes went just so big, he didn't know. We said, it is a relationship with the Lord. He died so that he might come live in your heart and so that you not be alone anymore. He said, he'll never leave nor forsake you. The comforter is with you, is in you. He's our comforter, he's our paraclete. He comes alongside us and he restores us. Amen. So this morning, I just want to give you some facts, because I'm a historian, you know, I love history. So I'm going to give you a bit of a facts. Many people, they don't believe that he died again. And if you don't believe he died, you don't believe that he's resurrected. And many people think it's a fairy tale. This is a story like Cinderella. No, it is a fact. Jesus died. That's why we say before Christ and after Christ. It's a fact that he died. If I say the word Ukraine now, everybody knows, oh, there's a war somewhere. Am I right? Putin. Have you heard the word Putin? Have you heard the word war in Ukraine? Do you know Putin? Did you touch him? Did you spend time with him? No, but you heard about it. Amen? Faith comes by and hearing by. And you know what? A witness. If something happened to you, an accident happens, or God forbid, or anything like that, there's always a witness. What is a witness? Anybody? It's somebody that was at the actual event that saw what happened. Am I correct? And if they give the witness, you are guilty or you're not guilty. So we see that in Acts 13. We see that Paul, Apostle Paul, he gave his first preaching. He started preaching for the first time. And we see that he, 3 years after Jesus died, Jesus appeared to him in bodily form. Can you remember on his way to Damascus, Jesus appeared to him and said, "Why are you persecuting me?" Can you remember that story? Now, this is He started preaching 10 years after that. So this is 13 years after he had an encounter with Jesus. Now, he didn't personally touch Jesus or followed with Jesus, but he heard about Jesus and he had an encounter with Jesus that changed his life from a murderer to the most powerful evangelist. Jesus can change a nobody to a somebody, a prostitute to a righteous person, a liar and a thief to a righteous person. Isn't that awesome? Jesus can change anyone. He changed me. And I was very hard to change because I just believe in facts. I believe 1 + 1 = 2. And my husband spoke to me about faith. And he used to tell me, Patty, you're going to see this is going to happen. That. I said, really? Really? I didn't have a lot of faith. But when I had an encounter with Jesus, he transformed my life. He is real, people. He's real. He's alive. He's amongst us now. He says, where two or three are gathered in my name, here I am in the midst. He is so real. He's so faithful. And though they found no cause for death in him, they asked Pilate that he should be put to death. There was no cause for Jesus to be put to death, but because he took our sin upon himself. He laid down his life. We heard everyone. We heard all the prayers. He laid down his life for us to take our pain and our shame. He laid down his life. A million of angels, a legion of angels could have rescued him. But you know what? He sent the angels to be our ministers. Do you know that? We that are the children of God, we have angels that's ministering to us. Did you know that? It's in the Bible. It says, now when they had fulfilled all that was written concerning him, they took him down from the tree and laid him in a tomb. So do you see there? Now when they had fulfilled all that was written concerning him. It was fulfilled. It was prophesied that he will die and he will rise again the third day. Am I right? He also said to the disciples, listen, I'm going to die, but the third day I'm going to rise again. Did they believe that? I don't think so. Because when he died, they were all crying and they were sobbing and some of them ran away. It was just Mary and John that I think was at the cross, at the foot of the cross. You see, faith comes by hearing. They didn't hear the word of God. It's important to listen to the word. It's important to read the word. Because if you read the word, it will prepare you for whatever comes your way. Do you know that? God prepares you for everything that comes your way. But you need to be attentive to the word. You need to read the word. And he will prepare you for what's going to happen to you. And he prepared them. Since Genesis, it says the seed of the woman will crush the head of the snake. And it was the final crushing at Calvary. Amen? We see, but God raised him from the dead. He was seen for many days by those who came up with him from Galilee to Jerusalem. He was seen for many days by those who came up with him from Galilee to Jerusalem. Who are his witnesses to the people? We have credible witnesses. We have more than 500 witnesses that saw Jesus in his transformed state. Amen? They saw him in his transformed state after he arose out of the dead. And we declare to you glad tidings. Glad tidings, good news. We bring you good news. news, says Paul. We bring you good news of the promise made to the fathers. There's the promise. Amen? The promise is that he will die, but he will rise again the third day. That is the promise. And did he do it? Yes, and it's an amen. I believe that Jesus died, and I believe that he rose the third day. There's evidence, there's facts about it. Like Mandela, Mandela was on this earth. He did die. Amen. He did die. It's in the history books. The same with Jesus. It's a fact. He did die, but he didn't remain dead. Many people believe somebody that's got a PhD, hey, but they can't say the next minute if they're going to be alive. Jesus knew when he's going to die and when he's going to be resurrected. Am I right? We must believe what Jesus say. Amen? We must believe what he say. People cannot predict the next minute. But if you believe in him and you read the word, he said, I will show you things to come. Amen. So in Romans 6 verse 4, it says, likewise you reckon yourselves to be dead indeed to sin, but alive to God. Am I the right one? Oh, no, sorry. Now if we died with Christ, we believe that we also live with him. Amen. The Bible says if we die with him, we will live with him. If we endure with him, we will reign with him. Knowing that Christ being raised from the dead dies no more. Amen. He dies no more. Death no more has dominion over him. Praise him. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ. Death has no dominion over him. He was a man like me and you, a woman like me and you. Sorry. He was a man and in flesh and a woman like me in flesh. But he died and he rose again. The Spirit of God entered him and raised him up. Amen? For the death that he died to sin one time. But the life he lives to God. Isn't that awesome? We must live our lives to God. We must be surrendered to him. And you know what? If you are, the Bible says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind. And then you will just not know God's good will, just not God's acceptable will, but God's perfect will for your life. If Christ has not been raised from the dead, if Christ has not been raised, then our preaching is in vain. I can't say I'm a Christian if Jesus did not arise from the dead. Am I right? Our faith is built on he died and he rose again. If they find his bones today, then there's no more faith. Am I right? We can't say we Christians. The cross is empty. The tomb is empty. Jesus is alive. Amen. It says that if Christ has not been raised, then our preaching is in vain. And your faith is also in vain. Why are we so afraid to spread the gospel if we have the truth? Jesus did die. It's a fact. And he rose again. Amen. For if the dead aren't raised, neither has Christ been raised. If Christ has not been raised, your faith is in vain. You are still in your sins. Thank you, Jesus. Then they also who are fallen asleep in Christ have perished. No, they have not perished because Jesus died and he rose again. It's evidence that if our people, you know, when we bury them, we lay them down, that's the incorrupt, there's a corruptible seed, their bodies go into the ground, but their spirit is with the Lord. Amen. And then on resurrection day, the final resurrection day, the spirit and the body will become incorruptible and it will change just like Jesus' body we will have. After Jesus arose from the dead, he appeared to his disciples. Do you know what? He could eat fish. Yeah, there was a barbecue at the beach and he could eat. And he knew every disciple's name. He knew Thomas. He knew Peter. So when we come back from death to life, it means, you know, when Jesus came and he was resurrected, he wasn't confused. He knew who was who. When we are resurrected one day, we will know our brothers and our sisters, our mothers, our husbands, our wives. Amen? Isn't that awesome? We do not need to fear death. Death has been overcome. Isn't that powerful? Wow. Amazing. If we have only hoped in Christ in this life, we are of all men the most pitiable. What does that mean? Our hope is in the resurrection power of Christ. Therefore, being by the right hand of God exalted and having received of the Father the promise of the Holy Ghost, he hath shed forth this, which we can now see and we can hear. He's at the right hand of the Father, and we can see and we can hear. Blessed be the God and our Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy had begotten us again into the lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled and faded not away, reserved in heaven for you. Isn't that awesome? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I'm going to end off now with this scripture. I want you to listen carefully. It's in Mark 16. You can read at home. And that after he appeared in another form unto the two of them. And as they walked, they went into the country. And they went and they told it unto the residue. Neither believed they them. They told the disciples they don't believe. Afterwards he appeared unto the 11 disciples as they sat at meat, and upbraided them with their unbelief and hard of heart, because they believe not them which have seen him after he was risen. He told them he's going to die. He told them he's going to arise the third day. They still did not believe. We see the one that went to his tomb. What was she called? Mary Magdalene. She was delivered by Jesus, drove out 7 demons out of her. Mary, the mother of Jesus, she received and was witness when he was born. Here's Mary Magdalene. She was there when he came out of death. And she was the first one to be reborn. Isn't that awesome? Mary Magdalene was there when Jesus came out of death. And he said to them, go ye into the world. Preach the gospel to every creature. What are we meant to do? This is his heart towards us after he arose from the dead. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. Amen? You must be born again. But he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. It says these signs will follow them that believe. What does that mean? When you go and do what he said, the signs will follow you. Amen? I have seen with my own eyes the blind can see. I've seen with my own eyes the lame can walk. I've seen with my own eyes that the addicted ones, or those that are in bondage of fear and anxiety, being set free. I've seen it with my own eyes. So that signs will follow you if you start doing it. Amen? And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, they will cast out devils. They shall speak in new tongues. And they shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Amen? If you're not going to do it, it's not going to happen. Amen? Just ending off the last scriptures. Thank you, Lord. And they shall recover. Let me just go. So then after the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven. And he sat on the right hand side of God. Amen? Amen. And they went forth and they preached everywhere. The Lord working with them. You see there? The Lord was working with them. The Lord wants to work with you. But if you're not going to do it, nothing's going to happen. And confirming the word with the signs to follow. That is the promise. To do what he called us to do. He said, greater things will you do because I go to the Father. Amen? But then he left us with another promise. He fulfilled all the other promises. Yes, signs and wonders we see now. But he left us with a bigger promise, and he's going to fulfill it. He says, I'm coming soon. I'm coming soon. The way I came, I'm coming again. And I'm coming to fetch my bride. Isn't that powerful? He fulfilled his promises, all of them. It was a fact that he died and he rose again. His promise that he will arise out of death was fulfilled. His promises, and now his next promise, we can believe he is coming again. Amen? Let us give him a hand. Let us give him thanks. I see Jesus, he heals, he saves, he delivers. I see they are creating masks. When they say, don't look at these things. I said, I see robots being made. The robots are speaking like humans and interacting. I said, but they cannot bring the death to life. You can have how much money, you can't come back from the dead to life. Just Jesus. Amen? Amen. I'm just going to read you past the scripture. John 21, verse 27. Then he said to Thomas, reach your finger here and look at my hands. Reach your hand here, put it in my side. Do not be unbelieving, but believing. And Thomas answered and said unto him, my Lord and my God. Jesus said unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed. Listen to this. Blessed are they that have not seen and yet have believed. Isn't that awesome? Who's the blessed ones? We are the blessed ones. Woo! Woo!
Oh, praise the Lord. Can I have the band to the front, please? Amen. Are you still excited? Excited still what the Lord is going to do this morning? Amen. Without him, we can do nothing. That's why he paid the price in fullness for me and you. To walk in the fullness of the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Bless you. Amen. Amen. God is faithful this morning. There is no secret. I want you to know that God cannot do. Amen. I believe this is your time and your season for new beginnings. Can I have an amen? I said this is your season and your time for new beginnings. Can I have an amen? If you believe it, you will receive it. Amen. And it will happen. It will give birth. As you believe, so it shall be. Amen. I was just going through the life of Jesus. Especially when they nailed him to the cross, before they even nailed him to the cross. When he came into the city and he said, I inquire the two donkeys, loosen them. As he came through the city, Jerusalem, they threw their clothes in front of him. The palm leaves in front of him. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. They lift him up. They were so mindful of him. You see, they were looking for a military man that could set them free. In their very own village, they were in bondage. They were looking for the answer. God is the answer. What they were looking for was right there. But they were blinded. They couldn't see it. They were depressed because of what was happening around them. And Jesus came to bring peace. What was so powerful for me? When Jesus appeared to his disciples, and our brother Thomas, that was like us, was there. We were all Thomases in our days. Before we knew the Lord, we used to doubt it and go without it. And they told him, he was here. 8 days ago, he was here. He said, no. Until I put my finger in his hands and in his side, I will believe. That was me and you. We wanted to see. Seeing is believing. And hearing is no invention. But what was so powerful, when they crucified, he heard about it. He believed it. And he received it. And he fled. He wasn't there. He ran away. He moved. Wherever he went to. He went to look for peace. And try to work it out himself. But as God is so powerful. Blind saw, the lame walk. All these things compromised through his mind. Where is he now? They said they killed him. But you know what touched me? When he appeared in the room, the door was shut, it was closed. He appeared to the disciples, and doubting Thomas was there. When Thomas saw him, and he said, put your hands. You know, when Thomas saw him, he said, oh my God, my Lord. Oh my God, oh my Lord. This is me and you. When we didn't know him, and we begin to see the hand of God, and the power of God, and the anointing of God, doing signs and wonders, we begin to say, oh my God, did you see that? Oh my God, did you see Brett? Was it 3 ribs? No one could help him. Oh my God, he said that the Holy Spirit where he was came over him and delivered him. Is that possible? All things are possible to those who believe. Amen. Amen. And right now, I want to call up Brett to the front. I also want that young man that came with Pastor Sophia to also come to the front, my son. I want you to listen to the Holy Spirit, what the Holy Spirit did in their lives. Amen. But I also want Cindy is here. Makasa, come, my sister. I want you to come. Alistair, just stand there too. Amen. Aman, there's so many. There's a young man that I also prayed for him with his eye that was going to be blind. What's his name? Yeah, tell him to come. Aman. And Mr. Lupus is here too. Marco Lupus, yeah. Marco. So Lord, Mr. Lucas. Well, no, you meant me. Marco, okay? I want you to stand there. Stand there. Is Marco here? Okay. Come and stand this side. The different move of the Holy Spirit. There's so many others out there that I can call. There's Natalie can also come here. Is she here? Okay. I want you to understand this morning the power of the Holy Spirit. He had to die to give us life, everlasting life. Should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that who shall ever believe it in him should not perish, but have eternal life. I also want my brother there that was on heroin for 15 years, just come and stand there. Anthony. Mr. Tana Mana. Amen. Amen. This man is working for a doctor now. He since I prayed for him, he's going from glory to glory. He moved to Fanach. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, Tony, you must stand that side here too. Stand that side, huh? I'm just going to ask them things quick. I want faith come out by hearing. I just want you know, when he ascended today, amen? He said, greater things will you do. Me and you, greater things. Amen? Greater things will you do. Now, I want you to just very short. She was suffering with asthma for how long? When the Lord touched you, was it immediately gone?
Amen. Instantly healed.
Praise the Lord. Give it to him. Can you hear? Give God praise. Amen. He came for prayer.
Yes,
and I prayed for you.
Yes, Pastor.
Were you set free immediately?
Immediately, Pastor.
Oh, give God praise. He's a groot saak, Lupus. They said to you, there is no cure?
Yes, Pastor.
So when I prayed for you and you put the oil, what happened?
Healed immediately, Pastor.
You said when you took off that scar and that hole was closed?
Yes.
Oh, give God praise. Young man, you were blind, getting blind?
Yes, Pastor.
And when I touched you, did you get to receive your healing straight away?
Yes, Pastor.
Oh, give God praise.
Chemo. The Jackie, his mother and his grandmother's there at the back.
Oh, praise the Lord. Praise Amen. The Lord.
It never worked for him.
It never worked for him.
The Sunday we prayed, the Monday went in and they wanted to start the chemo and the chemo never worked for him.
So Jesus healed you. Praise the Lord. Give Amen. God praise. Amen. As Jesus, I can't my kids and yes, can afsit. Man, I had a gesin in a wheel. I saw her sitting in a wheelchair like that. I said, what do you want God to do for you? Yes. She said, if I can just wipe the nose of my child. Ask my neighbor, can I say, yes, she's come off here. If I can just wipe the nose, Pastor, I can't move. And God granted to her right there. You know, she fell over the wheelchair and she started vibrating. They wanted to say, leave her! Can you see the Holy Spirit is busy with her? Were you healed?
Lord touched my hand, immediately my hand was touched.
Praise
and
the
I
Lord.
Could use my hand.
Praise the Lord.
And Lord touched my legs. I was lame, I couldn't walk, and Lord just touched me and I was walking and speaking because the doctor spoke a lot of things over me. By my grace and the Lord
Amen.
Touched me and I knew.
Woo! Because of the blood of Jesus, because of Calvary. Listen to this. They said you will never have children again.
Yeah, they told me I will never be able to bear children after the Guillain-Barré. But when I walked into Revival Ministries.
how many children have you got now?
Not one, but two.
Woo! Give God praise. You're listening and you're sitting out there with doubt. God is still at move. The power of God is still available for you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. This man disappeared. I don't know why. He was like doubt. He was gone for 7 months. I think, Patty, where did he go to my son? He's gone overseas or what? I know he's blessed, but where is he? And he phoned me one night. He said to me, Pastor, I'm busy dying. Listen to this. I'm busy dying. I said, no, it's not the time to die. It's the time to live. You are still too young. The cross and the blood is before you. Who can be against you? What disease can be against you? And you know what? As I prayed for him, his wife had to also be here. When I said amen, his wife got up. And those that was helping him was busy dying in the other room. He called in his children to tell them, there's the will and everything. You know, that's why all these children, even those that's connected with them, they got such a hunger and a passion because of the cross, because of the blood, that I tell you, it's unbelievable. I shared with them, man, it's just so real. The love that they got and the power that fills them daily, even as they come for prayer every week, you can see just being filled because God answered their prayer. I can imagine what went through them when their father and mother told them that we're dying, we're not going to die in hospital. You know, people died in hospital with advantage that we're dying here. And I want you to know what is so powerful because of the cross and because of the blood of Jesus. Oh, and because he ascended to heaven. Let me tell you, you can imagine what their children said to the Lord Jesus. If you save my mother and my father, I will serve you for the rest of my life. Amen. That is exactly what Brett said. Amen. Oh, this is another story. Listen to me. I prayed for him. And as I prayed for him and his wife got up, healed, went to work. They got a business over the way they bought it, that field there. Oh, it was another miracle. That's another history, another story. How they could get that grounds because the guys that was with him that wanted the ground. Everybody else is afraid of them. But he stood in the power of God. I'm claiming it in the name of Jesus. And he got it. Give God praise for that. Yeah. Is there something you want to tell them? Short and sweet. I know you can speak all night.
Whatever you came with this morning,
amen.
No matter how big it feels Hallelujah. For you, God is here this morning to change your circumstance. God is here this morning to change your lifestyle. God is here to change your marriage. The anxiety that comes up on you, God is here this morning to change that. God wants a willing heart. You need to set yourself available for God to move through you. So when you come up this morning, say, Lord, here am I. I'm putting everything at the cross for you. Amen. Amen.
Come here, my son. Come here. Is it now the second time that we met? Huh? Yes. I asked him. He said to me, thank you, Pastor. Thank you. I look at him. You know what is so powerful? Alistair forgot to say one thing. They've contacted him in the week to say, are you still
alive?
Hey!
My company phoned me to find out if I'm still alive. So I've been at home for 2 years. Can you believe it? And even they spoke to me over the phone. They still want to video call me. And I have to have my ID in my hand to make sure I'm still alive.
Wow.
To God be the glory. Great things here.
Look what the Lord has done. I asked him, I can go back to the way I used to be. Do you know that, Eddie? Oh. Dorothy, you're supposed to know it. Darren! Amen. But you know this young man. He was on drugs. We're talking about the Holy Spirit today. This is what the Holy Spirit means to him, as he will share it now. You know, for 8 years he's been on drugs. that Pastor Sophia brought him. I prayed for him over the phone. This is now, and the Holy Spirit shall come upon you. I'll have to go. The Holy Spirit came over you. What happened, my brother?
Look, Pastor, this is the first time I'm speaking in front of me.
First time. Give God praise.
Keep it close to you. A week before I actually decided to go into a rehabilitation center or a restoration center, my aunt came to me and asked me if I want to go. I played around with her. I didn't want to go, but I knew something had to be done. Then she prayed with me and left. That week, I didn't know she came here to the church, and she asked Pastor to pray as well. That entire week before I left to the rehabilitation center, I was restless. I was always sloppy, and I could never sleep properly at night.
Whoa.
The following week when I went, then she told me, Pastor prayed for me. And I couldn't understand why everything changed so drastically, because I rejected everything, even my family said. My mother said,
oh,
maybe one day, she had a dream that one day I will stand in front of a church and give my testimony.
Oh.
But
oh.
I always made a joke out of it, because I always thought, ah, she's maybe just trying to get me onto the right path. My grandmother told me something similar. I ignored her. But if I can say thank you, not only to Pastor, because I, be honest, I do believe that a prayer is very powerful.
Amen.
My aunt Sophia, she has tried her best to keep me grounded in Jesus and in faith throughout my life. But because of being stubborn and because of conforming to the things of the world, I never actually took note of what she was trying to teach me. But for the last, say, 7.5 weeks now, I've been clean. Yes, Pastor didn't actually pray for me here in church. My aunt came to church with a photo on her phone, and Pastor prayed over that phone. I'm not sure how it worked, but that's the message that I received. Since that prayer, like I said, I was completely restless. Couldn't sleep properly at night. I was being sloppy. I did silly things that never made sense that entire week. But one thing I can say is thank you not only to Pastor and everyone else in the church that prayed, but thank you to Jesus, because I really never knew what a friendship and a relationship with Christ is like. Woo!
Another young evangelist. Give God praise for this one. Amen. Come and stand here, my son. He's with me. If I turn, he turned. If I sit, he sit. Whatever I do, he follow me. And we see the fruits of the Spirit. You know, I won't tell him I will wear that, but we should address the same too. We saw in the Spirit. Amen? You know what is amazing for me is he's an auto electrician and also a diesel mechanic. Qualified, both qualified. Let me tell you. And he get 90-something percent in everything. But let me tell you, it's a gift. Listen to me. You know, he was busy with cars, changing this particular day. There was a lot of other cars standing. And this day, he was changing the fuel pump in a tank. He was so focused that he took the match and check, and he just heard a flame as high as the lit, as he could, this height, if it's not higher. And all the cars, they burned out, because when the flame came, he moved him and he moved the jack and the car fell on him. Now he can't move off the weight. But he said to the Lord, if you take me out, Jesus, I'll serve you for the rest of my life. And that's why he is so focused on God. I want you to understand. I can't go back to the way I used to be. This is what he's saying. But I want him to share it with you. Amen.
Amen. God Good morning, church. It's so blessed to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. You know, for me, it's really life-changing when I hear all the testimonies of, especially this man here. I hear the testimony and so many others that were caught up in addiction. And, it's a demon. You know, it's a demon. And, you know, we tried so many different rehabilitation centers, from the poorest till the richest, even those where you go in and when you say welcome to the people at the reception, your medical aid is depleted. Hey, that's how expensive it is. Amen? But, you know, there's only one healer in this place. There's only one healer. It's free, but it's not cheap. And that is Jesus. You know, He died on the cross and He rose again for me and you so that we could have everlasting life. Amen. So it's no matter what you're going through, if you have an addiction, if you're addicted to drugs, you're addicted to alcohol, pornography, whatever it is, He's the only way. He's the only way to be free. Amen. And that's what I've got to add. Amen. God bless you. Amen. So the day when the Holy Spirit came upon me, you know, when you are using drugs and you alcohol and friends and nightclubs and all these things come together with one another, you know, the day when the Holy Spirit came upon me, I said, I'm finished. That's it, I'm finished. And I took those that are in the building construction will know the fascia board. Fascia board, 6 meters by 4 meters. And I had nailed a cross, big cross like that. And I put it up in front of the house. I only made a hole this deep. And I expected that cross to stand. And let me tell you, that cross stood for years. Not shaken, not moved. No wind could take it. The rain couldn't move that cross. But that cross stood in front of my house as a symbol that I'm finished with the past. I serve the Lord and I will serve Him forever. Amen. I said, Lord, if You heal me, I'm going to serve You for the rest of my life. I won't be focused on the worldly things. You know, as a young man, you're very focused on cars, houses, all these things. I said, no. I said, Lord, I will be focused on You. And when I got focused on the Holy Spirit, all those things came. He gave me all my heart's desires. I'm not a guy that likes to speak about worldly things. You'll never hear me speak about houses, cars, boats, and these things. I'm not a worldly guy, but He gave me everything my heart desired because I put my focus on the Lord. Amen? Hallelujah. God is good. Amen.
Amen. Yes, we want to thank his wife also for always just being there. He's got the right wife. That's why he's so aligned. If it wasn't for that wife, had you not any pad geloop. Amen. But you know, there is so many others sitting here that had to die already. They're sitting here. But you know, can you put the camera on Desiree? Come out of a very spiritual home, she and her son. Got great faith in praying for so many people. Her son Eddie, you know, he was at the hospital. She contacted me. Nothing is working. The medicine that they're on, the stuff that he's on, is not working. And I saw her, you know, a faith in God for her son. And I stood with him. Me and she and Patty prayed there for a few hours. And he was there and they said, but there's nothing happening. It's almost like we're losing him. And we prayed. And I reminded the Lord, Father, but you raised this one. You touched this one. You anointed this one. And while we were sitting in the place, who will come in with the drips is this young man. Give God praise. Give God praise. It was that man. I want his mother to say a few words quick.
I just want to thank the Lord for the desire that Edwin had to come to church this morning. He asked me, even though we were a little bit late, Satan thought he was going to keep us away, but I said, we will not. We are covered by the blood of Jesus. We are going. And I just thank the Lord. I can't believe how Edwin could just sing. Yes. And I just give God all the praise and honor and glory. Yes. In August, I was in hospital for a month. No one knew what was wrong with me. I lost 14 kilos, but God raised me up again, because Amen. My story is for God's glory, which I'll Amen. Tell again. Amen. Praise you, Jesus.
Amen. A woman of faith, God will come in for you. No weapon formed against you will prosper. You know, I saw her this morning while you were singing, she was just crying. Ending herself of herself. That end is whatever I thought of him, Lord, or not. That's not going to give birth. It's giving birth. I heard a beautiful voice like a Jackson this morning. I always heard him singing, but this morning I heard he doesn't know what's inside of him. That is his career. He can make money. He can cut CDs. He's with the right people there on the stage. He's got everything in him. I was always in the entertaining world, man. So I know singing, but I could hear what flowed out of him this morning. It's like the Holy Spirit is preparing for the next level. Breaking up your fallow grounds and putting you into a new environment. And you will excel. Your dream car will come to you. You won't go look for it. It will come to you. Your gift will make room for you and bring you before great men. And those that like it shall eat the fruit thereof. Amen. You know this young man. Had four operations every time. It's 8 to 9 hours. And if they touch any vein in his head and it bleed, he will die right there under the operating table. And I had to sit there for more than 4 to 5 hours to cover him. Right there, just sit there and pray. I saw Tyron and Tanya and Nathan interceding for him with us, with me and my wife. Praying for him, and every time he said, the third day I will come out, and every time by the third day he comes out.
Amen. Amen.
Come out. They said it's impossible, but he comes out because of his faith. The yes. Lord is rising yes. up because yes. of the cross and because yes. of the blood of Jesus. Oh, he will rise up a standard within you. He will rise up a standard yes. within you. 25 years. But you believe and receive the word. I tell you, she never once skipped a service. And God is taking her from glory to glory. And today she's teaching the word to so many. Soul of 15 years. The word of God that became alive. Just raise him up. Incurable disease. There's no cure for it. Jesus healed. We got a doctors here. They know blind. God opened his eyes. Lame, paralyzed, giving way of walking. Yeah, we heard this wonderful testimony of this young guy. Just the word. I know, Pastor, we came with that photo and we prayed. And I claimed him for Jesus.
Amen.
A miracle, yeah. Another miracle. A creative miracle, not just to him, but to his whole family. Today he's on fire for the Messiah. You must not stop. But he loves the Lord. Give God praise. Give God praise. Thank you very much. This is just. You must all be that witnesses to the Lord. Be that witness. Be that witness wherever you go. Amen. The Lord just put it in my heart. When the Lord showed me Thomas, how he doubted them. And when he said, oh my Lord, my God. You can imagine what he saw in the side. No blood. Spirit. Spirit he saw. That's what, oh my Lord, my God. You are spirit. You are spirit today. The spirit of the Lord dwell within us. He said, I'm in you and you in me. He's in you for signs and wonders. He's in you. Shall we stand? Thank you, Jesus. Rosita.
Glory, glory.
Glory.
Yeah. Come on.
I asked somebody, who is this girl? Because I saw her walking there. And I didn't realize it's her. There's favor over this child. But this power of darkness wants to block what's inside of her. And I believe it's the Lord. I said, Lord, you showed me her. What you reveal, you will heal. Yes, she's standing. Because I know her by the green pants. Jesus, can we stretch to her? Father, that your will be done in her life. Right now, in the name of Jesus. Block it out, uproot it, burn it out in Jesus' name. Bring forth the healing, the divine healing, and the gift will come to the surface. Right now, every pain that you're carrying, every past is blocked out in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Blocked out by the power of God. It is finished, my sister. It is finished. Arise, said the Lord. I've called you. Arise. Arise. Arise in the power. Arise. 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 Arise in the power. Jesus.
You deserve.
Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Open your hands, and the power of God will come upon you, and you shall receive power. Jesus.
We don't understand that.
You healed her. You healed her. You restored her. Still stretching with me. Haman, there is no secret that the Lord cannot do this morning. Where's your operation? Somewhere there? Okay. Lord, so the Lord is already over. Just take your glasses there. Don't you move. Just stand in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is already over you. The Holy Spirit is already doing the work for you right now. Right now. I will take sickness away from the midst of you. From the midst of you. The prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise them up. And if they committed any sin, they will be forgiven. Oh Lord, I thank you for the healing right now. To your daughter, Father, your daughter. In the name of Jesus. Right now. In the name of Jesus. I command the healing. I command the healing. Right now in Jesus' name. By your stripes we are healed. Yeah. name. In Jesus' name. Break it up, root, Lord. Uproot. Out of his belly will flow rivers and streams of living waters. Living waters. Just keep looking to the Lord. 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 Spirit of the Lord. Spirit of the Lord. Spirit of the Lord. Touch. 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 Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Set you free today. Amen. Today is the day. Father, I release your power. I release the anointing of the Holy Ghost over. Set her free. Set her free, Jesus. Set her free. So many of them, Lord, watching. In the name of Jesus, I release your healing virtue over them, Father, to set them free from the crown of the head to the soles of the feet, Lord, that they will forget the former things. Behold, I'm doing a new thing, that they will receive the new thing, Father, for the transformation of their soul. Spirit, soul, and body, in the name of Jesus, Father, that every sickness and every disease shall leave now. I command it to leave in the name of Jesus. We take authority over that. By his stripes we are healed. And even those to this afternoon, Father, that need to give their lives to the Lord. Father, today they realize I cannot do it on my own. I need Jesus. He died for me on Calvary. He shed his blood for me to be free, that I can be free from these things, that I can have eternal life, that I can walk around being free, every weight off me, in Jesus' name. Father, forgive them for their sin, for they know not what they do. In the name of Jesus, Father, this afternoon they confess and they repent of their sin. They turn to you this afternoon. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, they turn to you, Father. Forgive them, Father. In the name of Jesus, as they receive you as their Lord and their Savior. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Say, my life will never ever be the same again. I believe it and I receive it. In Jesus' name. Thank you for the cross. Thank you for the power of the cross. My life will never ever be the same again. If you believe it, give him praise. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen.